So for me, it means a lot because I had a chance to be, first of all, adopted when I was a young kid. I was born from an African mother and I was adopted from a European mother that was in Switzerland. So straight away, I had a chance to see the difference of being in Africa and then being in Europe. And I always thought that, why me? And the activism was all to be active, to give back and to show something different to people in Africa around the world was always been with me as a young age. And that's why as well, as soon as I got and I made money, I wanted to give back something to Africa and I made a foundation for, not for footballers, but just for kids to get their own educations, to have the chance to go to school and to become someone in life with my agent, you know, because in Africa, or in, let's say in country where you have less possibility, like life starts at a very young age and you become a woman and you're only a kid, you become a man and you're only 5 or 6 years old. And we wanted really to give those kids a chance to grow up as normal and to have a normal chance in life.
Actually, the word itself, success, is not a word that I really love, because sometimes it's related with material success, with, in case of football, trophy success. And for me, it has 100 different interpretations in which, from a personal point of view, go beyond the football pitch. So in my personal case, being part of Common Goal, being part of amazing people like Johan and Sophie gives me really a deeper meaning of what being a football player is. I have been lucky enough to play for a number of years now as a professional football player and win trophies and live incredible experiences thanks to football. But to be able to be part of a movement which is trying to connect football and use football, the power of football, as a social tool for change, I feel that it's creating a legacy. That after we stop playing football, all of the Common Goal members, we will feel proud that we have started a way in which people can actually help through football, and we have created a platform in which it doesn't matter what level of football do you play, it doesn't matter if you're a fan or a journalist or a psychologist like you are, you can join what we want to create, the biggest club in the world, and it gives me an incredible sense of pride, of hope, and of passion for what I do on the pitch, but especially off the pitch.
I could be able to achieve my dreams on the football pitch by being a very selfish person, but I don't want to be a selfish person. So I have defined some values for myself, and one of those three values that I have and I try to act on is to be a contributing person, meaning that on the way to achieve my goals on the football pitch, I also want to help others. So that's why I'm also involved in these social projects. That's a way for me to express that value, to be a contributing person. So I think I would say that there are many ways to be purpose-driven, and of course people have different purposes. But I think whether your purpose is to win titles or you want to earn a lot of money, then the most important thing is how you want to achieve those goals.
This image needs to change that footballers or athletes are just robots and they're there to get the points or to win the league and they cannot have feelings. I think that's totally wrong because at the end of the day, we play with our emotions. When we are on the pitch, we play with what we have in our guts and in our hearts. We give everything to try and win and to make the people that follow us happy. So we definitely have hearts and feelings.
When I see, like David said before, teammates like Marcus Rashford or Raheem Sterling or Hector Bellerin doing incredible things, not with common goal, but with incredible purposes, it gives me hope, because I think football players, we are realizing the platform that we have, the ability that we have to reach to people and to communicate our values. So definitely being part of Common Goal has given me a bigger and deeper meaning of what being a football player is, beyond the trophies, beyond the wins, the defeats, and the goals.
First, I hope that as a female football player, I hope I can be a role model for girls and women and show them that football is for everybody. It's not only a sport for men, it's also for girls and women. So I hope I can, together with other all other female football players, can show that it's actually something you can do. And the project I have in Ghana I'm working with, I see how much it means to the girls there to play football. Yeah, I just hope that that more and more girls and women will feel like, yeah, I want to play football as well and will enjoy it. And then another thing is, I think that a lot of people look at the professional football world with some kind of contempt, that they hear about all the huge salaries, the huge transfer amounts. And I hope I can be part of pushing forward movements like Common Goal and Football for Climate and other good movements where we stand together as professional football players and try to show that the huge economy within the football world can be used to make huge changes.